Hi, my name is Peter Karare, a PhD student in Peace and Conflict Studies at the University of Manitoba. Today I'm going to talk about global citizenship. This is part of the contribution for the Summer Institute of Student Leadership and Global Citizenship, in which I am participating. And my discussion will be in two parts. Part one will deal with the definition of global citizenship, and it will also deal with the connection between global citizenship and globalization. Still in part one, I'll look at why do we need global citizenship. And then part two, we'll virtually discuss on does global citizenship exist? So, what is global citizenship? Is it just an illusion? Is it just based on mere cynicism? Is it a reality? Global citizenship or world citizenship refers to the concept of citizenship to a global level. It is the ethical or moral obligations of individuals to be committed to global responsibilities. The central foundation of global citizenship constitutes the respect for any and all fellow global citizens, regardless of race, religion, or creed, and it gives rise to a universal sympathy beyond the barriers of nationality. If I echo Thomas Paine, the American philosopher, in his Rights of Man, global citizenship could be summed up as, my country is the world, and my religion is to do good. So, what are the responsibilities of a global citizen? A global citizen actively participates and is committed to the reduction of all forms of inequality, discrimination, including all actions that hinder the well-being of individuals. Global citizenship, in other words, is not only an institution of individuals, but also a responsibility of local communities, institutions, nation states, region organizations, and ultimately the globe itself. So all have a responsibility to consciously recognize, accept, and respect their allegiance and obligations to the global community and the rights of world citizens. Towards this end, states and regions must break the barriers of nationalism and regionalism and engage each other in meaningful and genuine brotherhood. States must accommodate the global goodwill by enterprising on policy reforms and conforming to the international theory of idealism. My take, however, is that while the concept of global citizenship exists, the reality of global citizenship is still an illusion. While I do not dwell on skepticism or pessimism, it is important to note that global citizenship can only be achieved through a multifaceted approach. If I borrow from Prothero Steed and Howard Spivak in their book Murder is No Accident, published in 2004, global citizenship requires the critical mass and avalanche of initiatives at all levels and holistic engagements from individuals, local communities, national states, regional organizations, and finally global initiatives. All these efforts constitute a springboard towards global citizenship. So how does global citizenship link to globalization? Global citizenship has close links to globalization. Hence, to understand global citizenship, it is essential to define globalization. Scholars like Harold McGrew, Goldblatt, and Peraton defines globalization as the widening and deepening and speeding up of global interconnectedness. Another scholar called Waters in 1995 defines globalization as a social process in which the constraints of geography on social and cultural arrangements recede, and in which people become increasingly aware that they are receding. Globalization has enabled the connection of remote social units, This has facilitated political representations, humanitarian interventions, universal declarations and protocols, among others. When a child is born, he or she is a global citizen, but he or she is socialized to a certain inclination. A Kenyan, Canadian, Buddhist, Muslim, black, white, poor, rich, the list is long. With globalization, everything that happens in the world affects everyone. This is the revolutionary reality of the current century, but the world has turned a blind eye on this fact. This fact is best described by the World Service Authority. It says that a Middle East war raises the price of oil for everyone. An atomic bomb exploding in the South Pacific can mean leukemia for a baby born in Dayton, Ohio. Dumping radioactive waste off the coast of Florida can mean radioactive fish caught by fishermen off the coast of Iceland, Great Britain, France, or Spain. And why do we need global citizenship? The global effect of individuals' actions on the whole world is the foundation of the need for the global citizenship. Human beings must collectively intervene at all levels to address the harmful consequences of their own actions. In other words, if our actions affect everyone indiscriminately, then it is our duty to actively participate in reversing the harmful consequences. Global citizenship is thus about being trustees of our Mother Earth and of every human being, flora and fauna, towards ensuring the safety for all. As the Global Service Authority observes, global citizenship can be likened to the functioning of a human body. Each cell is linked to the whole by a nervous system directly connected to the human computer, that is the brain. For this almost unbelievable coordinated mechanism to order the necessary action required by a specific threatening situation, there is an instant feedback from the cells that are endangered. So it is about global, it is not about national or local. From the foregoing, global citizenship constitutes a progressive identity founded on moral and ethical values. It is a catalyst towards global responsibility. Global citizenship is not about we and them. It is about us and what we can do for the corporate benefit. How can global citizenship be developed and sustained? This can be done through global citizenship education, awareness creation, and sensitization about the meaning and importance of global citizenship. We must all think, feel, and act globally if we are to successfully cope up with the menace of potential catastrophes. Watch out for the second part. Thank you.